this like centipede like thing. Combination of the two, I think combination of the two, I'd say more to do with the military side of things, my lab kind of military abduction. I know there's, I've had encounters with things that I'd say weren't human. My only problem with that, one looks a bit like a sort of hoardling thing. One thing was like a sort of, like sort of horns and like sat on my chest, right here on my chest. Like a hoardling sort of thing. No tail, not like a sort of devil, but kind of looking at me. Well, just like a sort of impish, like sort of, quite fictional, but when it was looking at me, I was like staring at it. Nighttime, paralyzed, awake, eyes open, can't move. Again, I thought, is that just night terror? But there's physical evidence, you see. Physical evidence on my body. Burn marks, scar marks, the list goes on that I can't account for in any other way, apart from these experiences I've had at night or my abductions and stuff. So I'm sort of thinking, yeah, it's either, there's two ways of looking at it, either something like that was actually going on, which is more what my gut feeling tells me, or I was made to believe that and they were humans doing this. But I would say it's a combination of the two.
So,
working with extraterrestrials, working with humans, as in us being subservient to a...
What kind of extraterrestrials, and how do you know they're extraterrestrials?
Just non-humans?
Non-humans. What I mean
tall,
by...
Tall, yeah, yeah. Short, fat, what sort of description are you talking about?
Small, a lot of them. Quite small.
So how many are you talking about? 5, 10, a group of 100, a lot?
When I've had these experiences, when that centipede entered me, like sort of dinosaur-like centipede type thing.
Dinosaur-type head, but a centipede body?
Reptilian sort of head, like sort of thing. But there were humans as well there. And my brain was being operated on and stuff. And sounds a bit crazy, but yeah, they mucked about with my brain, like tension here. You remember blood coming out my nose and stuff, and coughing up bits of brain and stuff, and all kinds. Yeah. This is the bit that I've been suppressing for years. I've seen it about 3 times, maybe 4, where I've literally like hulked out markings on my leg. It's a line there. This goes black to white. That gets darker when I go into water, but sometimes when I get angry, that gets really dark on both legs, same marking.
Could you describe that again?
It's like that my leg there, it's like light there and dark there, goes right down to the bottom. I don't know what it is, but when I get stressed and angry, it gets darker. When I go into water, it gets darker. Can you see that? And people have witnessed my arms getting bigger, muscles getting bigger, some kind of super enhancement thing. I'm not sure. I've tried to suppress it because my way of dealing with things.
That's hulking out, as you say.
Yeah, hulking out. Yeah, literally hulking out, like arms getting bigger. Even my boxing trainer years ago said that I had the hardest punch he'd ever seen. No one ever hit like that, someone of my age. Actually said that to me. He would clarify if I spoke to him. He said, no one hits like that. You hit like Mike Tyson hits at the age of 15. I can remember my psychologist talking to me and saying, we don't know where you get your strength from, David. Where you get your strength from. We've given you 3 tablets that would knock most people out for 3 days.
Yeah.
And it's knocked you out for about 30 seconds. And you're at...
Do you know the tablets that they gave you?
Don't know what they were, but... They said he'd give them to people and they're out cold for 3 days and they're going
nowhere. There are some people who've got an ability to resist that.
Well, this is it. And my, well,
if that, you know, wasn't the chemical.
That wasn't just the context of what she meant. She actually said she wanted to know who my father was.